You all set, Levi? Raphael, you all set? Afia? You ready to go? You ready? Yeah?
Okay, so today we're going on a trip in the city to find out the principles of structural geology. So the reason I brought you to this bakery is because in Pernambuco, in Brazil, they have a special cake. Cake doesn't exist anywhere else in the world, not even in other states in Brazil, only in this particular state. And it tells you something. It's a perfect analogy for the study of structural geology. It's called Bolo de Rolo, and we would translate that into English as rolled cake. And I'm going to show you what amazing things you can do with this cake and how you can explain the basic principles of structural geology. So this is the cake. This is Bolo de Rolo. Check it out. Beautiful. So this is the most traditional kind, but the reason I've come to this bakery here is because they have a special kind of bolo de rolo, and I'm going to show you that one first. I've only seen this like two times in Recife, but this particular kind of bolo de rolo over here, check it out, is not rolled. It is layered like this. See? So normally you'd be walking along on top of the earth here and you wouldn't really appreciate what was underneath your feet. If you could see underneath, you'd see something pretty amazing. You'd see something like sandstone, you know, interlayered with layers of clay, for example, claystone. And sometimes what you might have is a slice at the landscape, like a hill going up, which will transect all of these layers. So let's just simulate that a minute. Let's create a hill, okay? And now what you see is you might, on the surface, you might be walking over several layers of rock. And you would notice that they were actually pretty thick. You know, there's a pretty thick layer here, thick layer here, thick layer here. But in actual fact, they're actually pretty thin. If you turn it on like on the side like that, they're actually very thin. But because you're taking a slice out of it like this, gives the impression that they're actually thicker than they really are. Now, so to correct for that, geologists use something called a compass clinometer to actually measure the direction and the angle at which these layers are being deposited. And that way you can get a much better idea of what's really happening underneath the earth. And what we can do in these sediments is we can create a fault right here, a zone of weakness, okay? So now the rock's been under pressure, now it's nicely aligned still. But what happens is, if there is some uplift or something like that, so the land moves upwards, and there's a zone of weakness here, these rocks can like fall downwards like this, okay? So under the weight of gravity, this will just fall down, this block will fall down relative to this one. This is called a normal fault. In contrast, if for example there was some pressure coming from below and going up, this might move upwards related to this one. And that is called a reverse fault. Okay? we go. So I've created a new cut here. Now let's say that this is, you know, the situation a few million years ago, and that there was some tectonic force from below and it's tilted all the rocks. So if I was to, example, have clays and sandstones. Well, sandstones are a bit harder than clays. So let's say the guava here is, are the clays. The guava is going to be eroded downwards like this. That's going to be taken away. Clay is going to be eroded, leaving the sandstone standing up. So what you get is the topography becomes more jagged. And over millions of years, you can actually, you know, take away more and more clay, this for example, and start to create ridges. And that's just a simple difference in the amount of weathering between the rock types. Do all kinds of things with this BOLO DE ROLO. Okay, so maybe in hindsight it was a little optimistic taking my two boys to the bakery to explain the concepts of structural geology. So I thought better of it and I've taken our cakes back from the bakery and I'm gonna do it here on my veranda instead. Okay, so here we go. But we already did normal and reverse faulting with the horizontal BOLO DE ROLO, but there's one other kind of fault that I wanted to talk about, or maybe two, and that is when one of these blocks moves perpendicular to the other one. So for example, this block could go like this, like that, okay, could come out, and that would be called a strick-slip fault, okay, such as the San Andreas fault in California. Okay, now if we're going on to the real BOLO DE ROLO, the circular one, this is where it gets really fun. Okay, so here you go. Now this particular structure doesn't really exist in large scales when we're talking about structural geology. However, this structure does. I'll use this one because it looks a bit more beautiful. Here you go. Now this is called a syncline. So you've got essentially the same as this, but the crust of the earth is stretched and thinned and the rocks have kind of deformed and bent downwards. Okay, so what you have is, you know, this layer here is the same as this layer here, for example, it's the same rock, and this layer here on the outside is the same as this one here. But you would never see that because this is all underneath the earth. What you would see is you'd be walking along the top of the earth taking samples, okay, on the surface. So you start with this one, siltstone, clay, siltstone, whatever, whatever, whatever. In the middle, you'd have something interesting. It would be like a sediment. And that's formed because as the earth has opened up, these sediments have sunk down, forming what's called a depot center in the middle, an area where sediments can come in and fill up. So you've got some different sediments in the middle, and then on the other side you have exactly the same sequence repeated but in reverse. So when you have that observation in the field, sediments repeating in reverse, you can be pretty sure that what you're looking at is a syncline. So as I was just finishing up there, Levi woke up, so I have to get him quickly. But I hope you've learned from this video the power of BOLO DE ROLO in explaining structural geology concepts. I've had some more ideas about how we can use the same analogy for doing sedimentology, so just keep tuned for that. Okay, the best thing about using BOLO DE ROLO for these kind of geology demonstrations is that you can eat it afterwards.
No, you can't. No.
Maybe about 4 months time, okay? Bye for now.